Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today I wanted to share this braided hairstyle. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. Be sure to subscribe and click that bell if you're new, and let's get started. With my hair parted near the middle, I'm going to begin by creating a Dutch braid on the left side of my head. I'm leaving out my bangs and a little bit of hair to frame my face. I'm going to pick up a section of hair on the left side of the part and divide it into three smaller pieces. Since I'm doing a Dutch braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands under the middle strand so the braid sits out on top of my head. So I'm crossing one side under the middle, then crossing the other side under the middle, and after the first stitch, I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. So I'm crossing one side under the middle, picking up a new section of hair, crossing it under and into the middle strand as well. Then I'm crossing the other side strand under the middle strand, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under, bringing it into the braid. And I'm just going to repeat those steps, working down the left side of my head. I brought in about four sections of hair, and I'm going to create the braid along the left side of my head, bringing in hair from the part line as well as from the hairline. Once the braid reaches the top of my ear, I'm going to stop adding in additional pieces, and I'm just going to continue braiding the hair in a Dutch braid, crossing the side strands under the middle strand, continuing the braid down to the ends. Once the braid reaches the bottom, I'm going to spray the braid with hairspray and then smooth down the edges before pulling it apart in order to make it look bigger and more full. So I'm just going to carefully pull the hair up and out of the braid so that it widens it. This will also make it a little bit flatter so it looks fuller. Then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps as before and create another Dutch braid along the right side of my head. So the steps are the same as the previous braid. I'm leaving out my bangs and a little bit of hair to frame my face. I'm going to pick up a section next to the part and divide it into three smaller pieces. I'm going to cross the side strands under the middle strand, and after the first stitch of the braid, I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid as well. So I'm crossing one side under the middle, picking up a new section of hair and bringing it into the braid, crossing it under and into the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the other side strand under the middle, picking up a new section of hair, crossing it under and into the middle strand as well. And I'm going to create the braid along the right side of my head, bringing in hair from along the part line and from along the hairline. So again, I'm crossing the side strand under the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under and into the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the other side strand under the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under and into the middle strand as well. Then once the braid reaches my ear, I'm going to stop adding in additional pieces and continue braiding the section down to the ends in a regular three-strand braid. So I'm still crossing the side strands under the middle strand, alternating between the left and the right side strands without incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. And once the braid reaches the bottom, I'm going to spray it with hairspray and then go back over the braid and gently pull the edges up and out slightly so the braid looks wider and more full. Then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Once both braids are done, I'm going to pin them against my head. So I'm going to lay the left braid over the right braid, and I'm going to slide my bobby pins into the middle of the braid, grabbing only a few pieces of the braid with each bobby pin, and then slide them upwards along the braid so they're hidden underneath the hair. I slid a couple into the center of the crossed braids, one on the top part and one on the bottom. A good rule of thumb is to pin wherever you're holding the braids in place, and I just keep pinning until they feel nice and secure and aren't going to fall loose. Once that's done, I'm going to divide off two sections of hair underneath both braids on the left and the right side. I'm going to bring these two sections together at the back of my head and tie them up using a clear elastic band. Then I'm going to flip the elastic band upwards and around itself so the two side sections are now twisted. And then I'm going to repeat those same steps and create another twisted section. So I'm taking a small section of hair from the left side and a small section from the right side underneath the previous twist. And I'm going to bring the hair together at the back of my head and tie them up using a clear elastic band. Then I'm going to flip the elastic around itself so the two side sections are twisted again. Now I'm going to create the elastic style braid. So I'm going to divide off two new sections again. These are going to be a little bit bigger than the previous sections, but I need a section from both the left side and the right side of my head underneath the previous twist. I'm going to bring these two sections over the top of the rest of the hair and tie them together using a clear elastic band. Then I'm going to go back over the hair right above the elastic. And I'm going to gently pinch and pull the hair slightly up and out of the elastic. And this will create the first puffy section of the braid. Now I'm going to divide off two new sections of hair from underneath the previous section on both the left and the right side. I'm going to bring the two sections over the rest of the hair like before and tie them together with another elastic band. Again, I'm going to gently pull on small sections of hair above the elastic so the two sections are bigger and look more full. And I'm just going to repeat those steps and continue the braid down the length of my hair, dividing off two sections of hair from both sides of the ponytail, tie them over the top of the other hair, and then make each section puffier by gently pulling the hair slightly up and out of the elastic. I ended up creating about six sections of the braid. I just went down the hair until I really couldn't reach anymore. You can do as many as you'd like or just a few. It's however you prefer your style to look. I think this is a really cool spin on a traditional braid, and it's a lot easier to do since it's done with elastics. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. Like and subscribe, click that notification bell as always, and I will see you next time.